the same preamble, Mawuli School. The volume is increasing when the radius R is equal to 6 centimeters. Yes, Elliot.
144 pi centimeter cube per second.
You're right. Next set, 10 seconds of your time, please. I have a preamble to all schools. Preamble. When I get to your school, I will give you a structure, a biological structure. Indicate the ploidy level of the given structure. I hope you got that. All right. Prempeh College, anther of a flower. Yes, Eunice.
Haploid.
That's incorrect. I am not... I'm not accepting. I will tell you in a bit. All right. With the same preamble, Aburi Presby, angiosperm make endosperm. Yes, Selom.
Triploid.
You're right. Mawuli, with the same preamble, the liver hepatocytes of an adult human being. Yes, Elliot.
Diploid.
One. All right, so now let me explain. Okay, so for you, yes, diploid is possible because it contains a heterogeneous mixture of diploid and polyploid. It's a mixture, right? Okay. And then Prempeh College, the anther of a flower, that is diploid. Okay. All right. Next set, 30 seconds. Your question, Prempeh College. A ring of mass, 0.050 kilogram, and radius, 4.0 centimeter, rotates from rest about its symmetry axis under the action of a constant 2.4 times 10 raised to the power negative 3 newton meter torque. Find the angular speed of the ring 2.5 seconds after it starts rotating. Yes, Lanel. Go ahead.
1.2. We'll find it. 1.2.
That's incorrect. Who rang for the bonus? Okay, go ahead. Elliot.
1.5 rad per second.
No. The right answer is 75 radians per second. Hmm. Every Presby. In a similar situation, a solid cylinder of mass 4.0 kilogram, radius 5.0 centimeter, and length 0.20 meter, rotates from rest about its symmetry axis under the action of a constant 0.15 newton meter torque. Find the angular speed of the cylinder 3.0 seconds after it starts rotating. Yes, Israel.
Okay. The angular speed is 90 rad per second.
You are right. Mawuli School. A 2.0 kilogram disc of radius 20 centimeter rotates about its symmetry axis under the action of a 1.6 newton meter torque. Please find the angular speed of the disc 2.0 seconds after it attains 60 radians per second. Emmanuel.
500 rad per second.
That's incorrect for bonus. Too late. The right answer is 140 radians per second. Next set, 10 seconds. Prempeh College. Polyvinyl chloride, PVC, is a synthetic polymer commonly used in the construction of pipes, window frames, automobile interiors, and so on, etc. What is the systematic name of the monomer unit of PVC? Lionel?
3-chloro-prop-1-in.
I'm not accepting that.
Theonary.
Yes.
Chloro-ethene.
Yeah, that's it. Your major question. Starch is a polymeric carbohydrate and a natural component of most plants. What is the monomer unit of starch? Salom?
Glucose.
One. Out of three. I'll tell you the reason later, okay? Mawuli, cellulose is a polysaccharide found in the cell wall of most plants. What is the monomer unit of cellulose? Emmanuel.
Alpha glucose.
That's incorrect. Yes.
Beta glucose.
Yes. It's beta glucose.
I wanted to say alpha glucose.
And now you know why. What's the right answer for yours? It's alpha glucose. Next set, 30 seconds with a preamble to all schools. Preamble. Preamble. Find a unit vector V perpendicular to and in the same plane as the given vector. I hope you got it. All right. So your vector A, Prempeh College, is equal to 6i minus 8j. Lionel?
4 on 5i plus 3 on 5g.
You're right. Aburi Presby, with the same preamble, your vector B is equal to 12i plus 5j. Yes, Salom.
So the vector is negative 5i on 13. Plus 12j on 13.
Yes. Mawuli School with the same preamble. Your vector C is equal to 8i minus 15j. Yes, Elliot.
15 over 17i plus 8j over 17.
Yes. Now, with this set of questions, I hope you realize that the opposite direction would also have been correct. So we had multiple possibilities for answers, right? Thankfully, you all got them right. Well done. Now, next set, 10 seconds, and I have a preamble to all schools. Preamble. When I get to your school, I will mention a type of pyramid. A type of pyramid. Please indicate whether the type of pyramid I mentioned to you is upright or inverted and give a reason for your answer. I hope you got it. All right, yours, Prempeh College. Pyramid of numbers. Yes, Lionel.
It is upright. And this is because as you move from one trophic level, that is from the lower trophic levels to the higher trophic levels, the total number of organisms present at each trophic level decreases, making this pyramid upright.
One. Again, I will come and tell you the reason in a bit, okay? Aburi Presby, with the same preamble. Pyramid of biomass. Yes, Salom.
the pyramid of biomass is upright, and this is because as one moves along the trophic levels, the number of organisms reduces, thereby the mass of the total dry weight of the organisms in each trophic level as one moves up reduces. And this leads to an upright pyramid of biomass.
One.
I wish.
Mawuli School, with the same preamble. Pyramid of energy. Yes, Emenyo.
Pyramid of energy is always upright. This is because as one moves up the pyramid or from one trophic level to another, energy is lost through respiration, excretion, and other methods. So therefore, pyramid of energy will always be upright because at the highest level of the pyramid, the energy is very small. But at the lowest level, more energy.
All right. Okay, so Prempeh College, the pyramid of numbers. It can be inverted or upright, depending. Okay, and what does it depend on? It depends on the number of producers. So let me give you a couple of examples. If you have a grassland ecosystem, the upright pyramid is what you are expecting, because the number of individuals at the level of producers will be maximum, right? Now, you also have individuals at the top, carnivores, that will be the least. You agree? Okay. However, if you take a parasitic food chain, it's going to be inverted because the producers provide food to fruit-eating birds, which in response support a few species of insects. So it can be either, right? Mm-hmm. Okay. And then for you, Aburi Presby, yours was a pyramid of biomass, right? That can be either inverted or upright. Again, if I give you the examples, grassland and forest ecosystem, it's upright. Because the quantity of biomass at the producer level is higher than the carnivore level at the top. So the pyramid is inverted. Let's say you take a pond ecosystem, as the biomass of fish far surpasses the biomass of zooplankton on which they feed. So depending on the scenario, you see that that's the kind of thing that happens. However, with the pyramid of energy, it is always upright, as explained by Emenyo. All right, next set, 30 seconds. Prempeh College, find the heat capacity at constant volume of 5.0 mole of a monoatomic ideal gas. Lionel.
6.3 × 10^1 joule per Kelvin.
That's incorrect. Yes, go ahead, Israel.
62 joule per Kelvin.
Yes. Your major question. Fine. find the heat capacity at constant pressure of 0.90 mole of a monoatomic ideal gas. Israel, go ahead.
Okay, so we have 23 joule per Kelvin.
That's incorrect. Yes, Elliot?
19 joule per Kelvin.
You're right. Now your major question. The heat capacity at constant volume of 1.5 mole of a classical diatomic ideal gas. Yes, Semenyo.
31 joule per Kelvin.
You are right. Next set, 10 seconds. And I have a preamble to all schools. Preamble. Preamble. Dodecane is a saturated hydrocarbon with 12 carbon atoms. That's the preamble. Now, Prempeh College, please explain the likely physical state of dodecane at room temperature. Lionel.
Dodecane is liquid at room temperature. And this is because the intermolecular forces of attraction between the molecules of dodecane are the weak van der Waals forces. And since dodecane has a large molecular weight and also a high surface area, the van der Waals forces are able to hold the molecules of dodecane together at room temperature. However, since the van der Waals forces are not strong enough, dodecane cannot be a solid. Hence, dodecane becomes liquid at room temperature.
Okay. Aburi Presby with the same preamble. Is dodecane likely to be soluble in hexane? Please explain. Salam?
Dodecane is soluble in hexane, and this is because the intermolecular forces of attraction between the molecules of dodecane is weak van der Waals forces, which is a nonpolar type of interaction. And the interactions in hexane is also nonpolar. And since these two compounds have like intermolecular bonding, they are able to interact with each other, and hence dodecane is able to dissolve in hexane.
Yes. With the same preamble. Thus, though they can have a higher or lower density than water. Please explain. Yes, Emenyo.
Lower. Though the cane has a lower density than water, this is because in water there exists hydrogen bonding while amongst the molecules, while in dodecane there is weak van der Waals forces, specifically induced dipole. So therefore, because of the hydrogen bonding in water, the density is higher than that in dodecane.
2 out of 3. Yes, it is lower. Remember, density depends on mass and volume, right? Dodecane has a large mass, but also a large volume due to the explanation you gave. You didn't link it to the volume. Your explanation did not link to the volume at all. But that is what is important. So due to the weak intermolecular van der Waals forces compared to water, which you are right, has stronger hydrogen bonding, the dodecane, although you have a large mass, you also have a large volume, and hence density is lower. All right. Next set, 30 seconds with a preamble to all schools. Preamble. Two fair dice are thrown, and the total score is 6. Please find the probability that, Prempeh College, the individual scores are both even numbers. Lionel.
3/5.
That's incorrect.
Don't worry.
Yes. Israel.
2/5.
Yes. Now, your major question with the same preamble. Your major question. The individual scores are both odd numbers.
Are both odd. So 1, 2, 3.
Salam.
3/5.
Yes. With the same preamble. The individual scores are both prime numbers. Elliot?
3/5.
That's incorrect. Yes. Lionel?
5. 1/5.
Yes. Next set, 10 seconds with a preamble to all schools. Preamble. When I get to your school, I will give you some characteristic, okay? Some characteristic. What you are to do is to distinguish between codon and anticodon with respect to the characteristic I give you. I hope the preamble is clear. So, Prempeh College, location. Yes, Yunus.
So, the codon is located on the mRNA molecule, also the anticodon is located on the tRNA molecule.
Yes. The same thing. Complementary nature. Selom.
The codon, the basis of the codon are the complementary basis of the DNA that it was being transcribed from. That's the codon, the basis of the DNA it was being transcribed from. Whereas the complementary of the anticodon is the mRNA codons.
Yes. With the same preamble. Function. Yes, Emenyo.
The function of the codon is to complement with the respective tRNA anticodons in protein synthesis to form a polypeptide chain, but the function of the anticodon is for it to be is for the tRNA to be able to pick a particular amino acid and bring it to the ribosome during protein synthesis.
2 out of 3. Of course, what you said was right, but I needed you to explain that the codon will determine the position of the amino acid. Okay, so it determines the position of a particular amino acid. And then everything else you said was right. All right, 30 seconds. Prempeh College. A 0.024 Newton sphere of radius 5.0 millimeter attains a terminal velocity of 3.0 meter per second in a certain fluid. Find the viscosity of the fluid. Learn now.
Is it which find it? Which find what?
2.5 × 10²⁻².
That's incorrect. For a bonus.
And then now.
The right answer is 0.085 pascal second. Every Presby, suppose the 0.024 Newton sphere of radius 5.0 millimeter attained a terminal velocity of 25 meter per second in a fluid at 80 degrees Celsius. What is the viscosity of the fluid at that temperature? Salon.
So I have the viscosity to be 2.0 × 10²⁻².
That's incorrect. For bonus. The right answer is 10 millipascal second. Mawuli School, find the viscosity of a fluid in which a 0.016 newton sphere of radius 4.0 millimeter attains a terminal velocity of 15 meter per second. Emmanuel.
It's too significant for this. 13 millipascal second.
That seemed correct for bonus. You were close. The right answer is 14 millipascal second. Last set of questions for the round. Last set. Prempeh College. Theobromine is the predominant alkaloid found in cocoa beans. It has a characteristic bitter taste and a molecular formula C7H8N4O2. A 200-gram sample of cocoa beans is found to contain 45 milligrams of theobromine. Please determine the mass of carbon atoms present in the theobromine. Now?
21 milligrams. 21 milligrams.
You are right. Every Presby. Wisanine. It's a natural alkaloid found in Piper Guineensis. This is a West African black pepper. And it has the molecular formula C18H21NO4. Determine the mass of hydrogen atoms in 180 milligrams of wisanine present in 10 grams of Piper Guineensis used in spicing food. Yes, Israel.
You mentioned like 7 milligrams or something.
Okay, so I have 380 milligrams.
That's incorrect. Yes, Elliot.
12 milligrams.
Yes. And now there's something interesting I have to share with you. Okay, those of you who want to learn something new today. Wisanine, this wisanine we just did some calculations on. It was first isolated and characterized in Ghana here. And the name comes from the local name of the Pipa or Piper Guineensis. Do you know which one it is, our spice? Srowisa. Yes. So, we have some claims to fame, huh? Piper or Pipa Guineensi, West African black pepper, Sruwisa, and the compound is Wisanin. How nice. All right, last question. Mawuli School. Quinine is an alkaloid first isolated from the bark of cinchona tree and used in malaria treatment. It has the molecular formula C20H24N2O2. Please estimate the mass of carbon atoms present in 540 milligram of quinine tablet. Go ahead, please, Lando.
400 milligrams. 400 milligrams.
That's right. And that's the end of the first round.